Hey, Pauli, what does the letter from the bank say? Well, what does it say?
It says I'm behind on the boat repayments. If I don't pay some money back, it says they will take the boat back.
What? You told me you were up to date with your repayments. Where's all the money?
Well, there was that farewell for Moses last month, and Sam Missy borrowed some money off me. I was hoping to pay it back this month when I caught some more fish.
Sam Missy, that loafer, where will he get the money from? From his cassava patch?
I thought there would be more fish this month. There usually is.
Can they really take the boat back?
According to this, they can.
What will we do? How will we pay them?
You know our friend Luke? He doesn't catch much more fish than you, but he seems to pay his boat off okay.
Luke is just born lucky. Even when I catch as much fish as him, I still don't have enough money at the end of the month.
Listen, why don't we go and see him and ask him how he manages? I'm sure he will help.
Will you come with me?
Only if you change your clothes.
Well, it looks like you have some problems here, Paul. Listen, I can help you, but we need to go through your records first.
I didn't have to worry about all that. I threw them all away. They just took up space. You seem to do okay. Sometimes I catch more fish than you.
Well, maybe I'm a bit more careful. You need to keep financial records to know how much money you're earning and how much money you're spending. Did you do a feasibility study before buying that boat?
Yeah, the bank did all that. I didn't understand it all, to be honest. I was excited about getting a new boat.
Yeah, it's a great boat. But you do need to understand what a feasibility study is.
Well, you can tell me, Luke, what's in this feasibility study?
Well, it's a series of surveys filled out in forms and has three parts to it. First is a technical part where they see what boat, engine, and fishing gear you would need for the job you're going to do and what it will cost. Then they check to see how much fish you can catch. The third part is the market feasibility study. This is where they can check if you can sell your fish, that the market is reliable, and what price you will get for your fish. With this information, they add up all the costs, both fixed costs and variable costs. Then they work out what you will get for your fish and estimate how much profit you will make and if they will give you a loan.
Paul, I have over here the latest figures for your business, and it looks like you'll be losing $1,500 every month. What are you going to do about it? Is that all you can do?
If I understood this feasibility study, maybe I wouldn't have got a loan in the first place.
How much interest do you pay on your loan?
I don't know. They take it all out with the repayments.
We pay 12% interest per year.
Well, I got my loan from the development bank. They charge 10% per year. See, already my costs are lower than yours.
What are these variable and fixed costs that you talk about, Luke?
Well, see, variable costs are like running costs which occur when you go out fishing. These include things like fuel, bait, ice, and fishing gear you might lose. Fixed costs, on the other hand, are costs that occur whether you go fishing or not. Things like boat repayments, interest and insurance.
But I don't have to pay these fixed costs every trip. I pay the bank every month and insurance every 6 months.
Oh, you see, that's the start of your misunderstanding, Paul. You must put aside money each trip, or you won't have the money available to make the repayments when it's due.
Hey, I can help Pauli with that. I was good with maths at school.
Hey, that's a good idea, Mary. Paul, you got a partner here who can help you, so why don't you involve her more? It'll take the load off you. Let me explain how you put money aside. Remember those good trips you had last week? What happened first? Your uncle came and said you had plenty of fish.
Well, you catch all these fish?
Yeah, last night. Do you want any?
Really?
So you can pick any.
Please, anyone. You're my favorite nephew, man. Thank you, my brother. Pinaka. Thanks.
Yeah, and remember what happened next? Your cousin Semisi came along.
Hey, cuz, nice catch. Better get you some money at the market. Speaking of money, cuz, is there any chance of borrowing a few dollars? Ooh, that's a lot. Thanks, cuz. See you next week.
Still, there's plenty of fish left.
We have only just started. Remember, you had to pay for your fuel. Are you sure that's enough?
Better take some fish out for Semisi.
Now comes the hard part. You need to put fish aside for the loan repayment and other fixed costs. And for the interest. Don't forget the insurance.
Is that all now?
Not yet. Your echo sounder doesn't work, does it?
No, I need a new one.
When is your outboard service due?
Oh, next month.
Better put some fish aside for that. Now what is left is yours, your profit.
I thought Pauli had made a lot of money in that trip, and we spent it.
Maybe that's why you're going broke.
But you can't put fish away like that.
No, but you can't keep financial records. Put cash aside to make those repayments.
Financial records. I knew there was a catch.
Look, what can we do to make our business more successful?
We see, Paul can catch fish, but he must sharpen up his management skills and start looking at his finances.
What's wrong with my management skills?
Remember last week when we went out together and the fish were really biting? You had to go home early and I caught 20 more than you.
You're out of bed and nice.
Yeah, see, that's bad management on your part, Paul. Listen, I hate to tell you this, but you just don't put enough time in when you're not fishing to look after your boat. You only fish for half a day because your gear's broken or you don't have enough lures. Sometimes, when the fish is biting, your vent's in trouble. Or not enough bait or ice.
It's not my fault.
Listen to Luke, Pauli. It's your fault.
But I don't want to keep financial records. If I wanted to do that, I would have become an accountant, not a fisherman.
Don't forget Mary. She is good at maths.
I'd like to help. How can we keep records, Luke?
Well, there are many ways. And I use the SPC logbook. Come over to my house and I'll show you. See, the first part gives the boat details, name, skipper, trip number. Look, this is my 23rd trip. This is how many days I went out. This was a 2-day trip. There's my crew pillar. You see, I fished on my way. Bottom fished off Cape Farewell overnight, then trolled a few schools of skipjack on the way back. There's the weather and the tide. This next bit is a catch by species for each fishing method I used and for each day I fished. Do you understand so far?
Looks easy.
Yeah, real easy.
The next bit is the trip costs. Everything you spent that trip. Fuel, ice, bait, food, gear, maintenance, and crew wages. This is what I got for my fish, and this shows what I didn't sell or kept for bait.
Does it tell you what color underwear you wore?
Detail is everything, Paul. You need it to run a business. Look here. Every 3 trips, there's a page which allows you to make any notes you want about the last 3 trips. You can see here, the tide was very strong, and I had troubles getting lines on the bottom.
So you have the trip costs, the variable costs, and the income. But what about the fixed costs?
We only need fixed costs once a month, so I keep that in a monthly summary book. Here's my summary for August.
I've added up all the costs for every trip I did that month. In the next column, I've calculated the fixed costs, loan repayments, insurance, and interest. This money here, I am putting aside to buy a GPS and an EPIRAP. Here we have the summary of the total fish I've caught from the trip records. You could itemize it all, but I've just added up the total value of the catch. The final box is where I add all the costs together and subtract it from the sale of the fish to find out how much money is left over for myself.
Could you do that?
I could do that.
Great. Now one last thing. This last page is where you can keep a yearly record by adding up the months.
Why?
Well, it gives you a record and it will be very useful in proving to the bank that you're a good risk for them to lend you money. Especially in the future, you might want to expand.
I think it's easy for me just to go out and catch more fish.
So you can lend more money to Semisi?
You don't quite understand, Paul. It's not about fishing more. It's about fishing smarter.
How's that?
Well, you see, if you go out more often, you catch more fish, but then you also have to pay more running costs. So you get more money, but then your running costs move up. Now these have to come off your catch.
Oh, I get it now.
Yeah, by fishing smarter, not many fish get away. Try keeping sharp hooks and good lures. Don't run out of bait or ice when the fish are biting. Hey, try doing 2-day trips instead of one. It'll save traveling time and fuel.
Anything else?
Yeah, get more money for your fish. This increases the total amount for your fish without any extra costs. Your profit moves up by that amount.
Oh, now I understand.
So can I. But we can't get more money for our fish. We can only sell to the local market.
Hey, I have an idea. If you put your fish and my fish together with another fisher, we can afford a taxi. Then we can go into town where the price is much better. Because we share the cost of a taxi, we can cover for the taxi fare from the extra money we make from selling in the town market. What's it?
Look, that's what I call fishing smarter.
Well, it looks good, and I can see how important it is. But I still have to make my repayments, and I don't have any money.
I'll tell you what, Paul. I'll help you and Mary put your books in order, work out your debts and your running costs. Now, Mary should be involved in the books from now on. Then we go to the bank and renegotiate your loan.
Do you think they will do that?
I think so. I have very good records showing that my boat, which is the same as yours, can make a reasonable profit. And a little more if you fish smarter. All we have to do is convince them that Paul is a better manager.
You hear that, Pauli? Well, I'll make some lunch, and then we can all sit down and do this together. Hey, what are you two waiting for?
Well, Pauli, I was a bit worried about you there for a while, but it looks like Luke has been helping you out.
Believe me, I'm a changed man now. Just call me Mr. Manager.
Pauli, if you've been having problems, the best thing you can do is to come along and see us. We really don't want to take away your boat, but if you don't contact us, what can we do?
I'm sorry. I was just worried about it so much.
That's okay. I understand. This is what we'll do. I'll cancel your late loan repayment penalties and reschedule your loan for another year. In this way, your loan payments will be lower. And from what you and Luke have shown me, this should be no problem. Look, this is what...
So how do you feel now?
Like a new man, Luke. Like a new man. How about you celebrate? Let's get some beers, eh?
Hey, won't Mary be waiting for you at home for some tea?
Yeah, you're right. Okay, we go.
Hey, you know what? We take some bottles home, it's cheaper, you'll save money, and Mary won't be angry with you.
You know, Luke, You not only fish, mother, you drink, mother.
I'll buy a few beers, man.
I'll do that, man.